So how's that for breadth and depth?
So what's changed in 90 days? How about everything? We've got some very significant foundational work that is going to serve us very, very well. Some of it has been started. Some of it has been already implemented. Some of it is going through that regular improvement. And we're failing at little things, we're succeeding at others, and we're modifying as we move along. I think the key element here is that that foundation is actually the launch point for other future ocean work, for the improvements and the daily operations. The daily huddles, I'm not sure what we did before them, because now I'm taking them for granted. It's a great innovation, and it's one that my colleagues right across the country are envious of, because theoretically they would say it's impossible to know every day what the pulse is of the organization. And I say, not only is it possible, it's being done here, right here, in this region. I recognize that a lot of the nature of this ocean has been focused on acute care by its very nature. The community-based work has been instrumental and very important. But I have to tell you, the whole of the region is really going to be involved in these next waves. We're going to have to continue that commitment. And the follow-on work is an incredible amount of work. So as we've initiated, we've got some really promising activity. But I wanted to draw and have you represented for you a chart of what it looks like as we implement Team 1's improvements, as we implement Team 2's improvements. And I'm going to use, for the sake of this presentation, the forecast that Team 3 has put together. So if we were to take a look, it says average of total over capacity. This is week by week. So you're seeing from the 16th of June through to March 29th of 2016. Here's the red line, which is don't do anything different than what we're doing today. And you can see that prediction. Zero is our notional capacity. That's always been, you know, if we get to zero, it's really 100% of trying to manage within. So the red line would take us well above. We keep on bouncing around. We probably go from a sugar high, you know, whereas we get close to capacity, and then be all upset because now we're back up and no one can figure it. Why? You know what? It's predictable. We've proven that. We've proven that we can predict into the future. Now, as we look at the prediction, what's interesting about this prediction, unlike the weather, you can question whether you can predict it or not, but the question, the real challenge, the capability we have is we can change the weather. We can actually change our future. So all of a sudden, look at the green line. This is with Team 1 and Team 2's improvements. All of the improvements that they already have in the hopper, some of them that they're seeking approval on, and this is the future. This is the green line, which is the prediction coming out of our 90-day ocean of where we're going to be week by week going forward. Now, there will be adjustments, right? We'll see come this summer how the southern hemisphere is doing with influenza, for instance. If they're struggling, we may have to adapt and change. We also know that irrespective of the macro picture, we still have certain areas that need additional beds. So if RUH is at capacity, and St. Paul's Hospital is really a realignment within the hospital, what gives here? Well, the answer is City Hospital. We've got this great opportunity, this great asset, this great capability of being able to use all of our services across this city and across this region. So we're open to it all, right? We are looking at it now from what is in the best interest of the patient, their family, the resident, the clients we serve. What is the best approach? Where is the best location? So I want to show you what happens next, and then I'm going to wrap this up. So you see up at the top, these are the dates. So June to September of 15. This is starting today into 15th of September, so over the summer. And then it goes from September to December, January to April of 16, and April to June of 16. So what you've got, we're going to have a process lead VP-led team that's going to hold and knit all of this together. Not just the Hoshin, but the follow-on activity. to be able to orchestrate and make sure that all of our systems are well organized, that we're not moving too fast and we're not moving too slow, it's just right, kind of that Goldilocks phase, right? Looking at the capability of the organization to move us through this, these improvement initiatives. The patient flow follow-on will be key. You don't do a 90-day ocean and then say, okay, now for something completely different, right? This is foundational. It needs to be now implemented more fully. We need to replicate our model lines. We need to continue with RPIWs and improvement work that sets for not only a foundation, but continuous improvement within that foundation. Safety team, 90-day prep, that little asterisk says there's going to be another VP lead there, another team or series of teams that allows that to move forward. We know on the safety team or teams, physician leadership on HSMR is critical. So the PAC has stepped up in terms of wanting to take their rightful place in leading HSMR, that's the hospital standardized mortality ratios, and the good work that's being done in terms of deep dives, chart audits, and our improvement on the safety and quality side there. They will move September 15th into action. And remember, the platform for safety is already built in this current and just finalized 90-day ocean. It's the same releasing of time to lead. It's the same team, pharmacist. We went through some of those roles and various players. It's the same being able to cascade and have in our daily huddles safety at the foreground, that it builds us the capability to now launch and to make safety our daily work. And then the follow-on, there's no doubt it will continue. Seniors team will be prepping. So they're going to be, again, a VP-led team or teams that are being prepared and actually decided upon. They will be doing the preparatory work so that in January of 16, they're ready to launch. Now, once again, how tough is it to envision on the platform of what we've done in Flow, the good work that we're doing in safety, to talk about how seniors across the care continuum will be served? Isn't that very consistent with ALC? Isn't it consistent with out of HSMR, our mortality numbers, that we're going, it's going to be pointing at areas like palliative care, pain control, pain management? We're starting to see now that these potions and how they inform one to the other and our good daily work that's being built in is now setting us in a course, and it's that way. And the reason I know it's that way is because that's where it's pointing. And we'll do course corrections together. And the key is, in all of this, we're together. This isn't just a couple people in a boardroom with some master scheme to say, here are the things that need to be done. I had no idea until today, until these last few weeks, and as the months emerged, where we would be. But I can tell you it's a good place, and it's thanks to everyone in this room. The 90-day prep on the next ocean, you see, starts January to April 16. That one right now is notionally reserved for children, okay? Pediatrics and children, so we're looking there. The only reason it hasn't been named and it's got a question mark on it is that we want to make sure that it's also informed by the good work that's leading up to it. So we will not overproduce, not present, you know, and you've seen some drafting of what the three-year potion layout might look like. But I got to tell you, some of this is going to be emerging in terms of more granular, more specific, and more actionable. So the potions are true potions, not oceans. Okay? What does it look like? Everything's changed. Who do we have to thank? I want to say a special thanks to each of the teams, VPs, the teams, the leadership, the point of care staff, the physicians, those who provide point of service right across the scheme. And I can tell you, as you saw these presentations, it's everyone from IT all the way through to the various HR, LR supports, all the way through to every profession that's represented, not only in this room, but in this region. I can tell you that the process engineering piece, the Kaizen leadership that's been shown in terms of all of our improvement capabilities, that is being brought to bear here. There isn't a skill or a background that we haven't been both delighted in, and then sometimes, in some cases, surprised as people step forward and said, volunteered, I know something about that. I can help here. That's the kind of, I want to be part of this, I gotta tell you. You know, it's one of those things that you want it so bad you can taste it. And whatever has happened here over the course of the years, I want to say to you, I'm so absolutely privileged to be here at this time. I just got really lucky in my career to be serving as your CEO. This team, these teams, the work that's going on is absolutely the heart of innovation. All we need to do is we need to keep it up, and we need to make sure that it's paced. This isn't about working harder. This is about creating the kind of pace for change and the focus and discipline to be able to continue to say we can be better every day. I want to thank each and every one of you, the boards, the foundations, everyone represented here today in everything that you've done leading up today. Today, in many respects, the work has just begun. Thanks.